Hi, I'm Andy with upandunder.co.uk. And today I'm just going to have a quick look through the equipment that I use up in Scotland during the winter for various climbing routes. So I'll start with my boots. These particular ones are the La Sportiva Trango Primes. Sadly, La Sportiva don't bring these into the UK, they're a special import. I personally got them just because they're incredibly warm, really lightweight, and also quite flexible around the ankle. I'm not a massive fan of wearing boots generally. I just find that climbing slightly harder routes, you sort of want that flexibility in the ankle. But ultimately, when you're buying boots, what you sort of want to look for is just sort of comfort, and just the ability to do sort of long walk-ins in them, and just something that's going to keep your feet really warm as well. So that's that. Second thing I look at when I go winter climbing is my helmet. At the moment I'm using the Petzl Meteor 3. I really like this as a helmet. It's really, really lightweight, really comfortable. I saw a lot of arguments over whether these polystyrene based helmets are strong enough and durable enough, but I've never really had an issue with it. I'm really happy with it. Just for such a lightweight piece, you know, it's always there and it always sits in the pack. My crampons, I'm using at the moment the Petzl Dart crampons. I'm a massive fan of monopoint crampons, and I've just found the Petzl Darts are the lightest. You can still walk in them as well. Unlike modular crampons with the different setups you can have at the front, these are so much lighter, they just give you, you know, so much more, you know, nice comfort. I'm just really impressed with them. For my ice axes, I've got the Black Diamond Viper axes. I'm a massive fan of climbing leashless. I went leashless about 4 years ago, and just everything becomes so much more easier. You can just take your hand off the tool, place gear, you can hand swap, standard hammer and axe setup. Just to sort of get over the insecurity of climbing leashless, I've used the Black Diamond spinner leash. Unlike other spinner leashes, it's got sort of this little swivel in it, so when you're sort of hand swapping and the axes are moving around, it stops you, you know, stops the leash getting tangled up, and then obviously stops the insecurity falling. It's just nice and springy as well. So there's the axes. The other thing I carry is walking poles. Now, I find these just really handy on the walk-ins. Obviously, just takes so much strain out of your legs. These, again, are new this year from Black Diamond. These are the distance poles. I really, really like these poles a lot. I hate having things attached to the outside of my backpack and things swinging around. And these just pack down so small, and they're really, really light. You know, there's just no reason for they're just so easy to set up and get them nice and latched up there. And just really nice pole. Really, really impressed with those. Clever bit of design by Black Diamond. Next thing to look at is the ropes. There's sort of loads of different theories around ropes and what to use. I personally just sort of stick with the double ropes, sort of traditional British thing really. Just allows you to, you know, climb zigzaggy pitches, your ropes don't get caught up. That makes abseiling a lot easier as well. You know, I've sort of played around with using single ropes and 6mm cord as pull downs and things, and I just find this system just seems to work best, and it just gives you so much more option, loads and loads of options with what you're doing. For my harness, I use the DMM Supercoor. It's an alpine based harness, so you can put it on standing up, so if you walk in your crampons, you're not then trying to fiddle getting your crampons over leg loops, you know, the whole thing opens right up. This one also has attachments for your ice axe clippers. Even if I'm not ice climbing, I'm just mixed climbing, not carrying ice shoes, I still always keep one on here just because I find that, you know, you can clip your axe to it if you need to. I also always keep on my harness where I'm going my belay plate. This is the old style Petzl Reverso, got a new one out now. Massive fan of these guide plate style belay devices. They just help if you know, in emergency situations, or if you bring up 2 seconds, or even if you just want to sit at a belay and leave it hanging over here while you have a cup of tea, get your nice warm gloves on, you know, and your second's still nice and safe. Now the back of my harness, keep just sort of my emergency kit, 3 prussics for abseiling, escaping system, rescue situations. And I also do carry a small knife with me in Scotland. You tend to come across quite a lot of pegs and old tat, which I, sometimes I need cutting off and replacing. There's just a few situations where I think a knife in certain rescue situations is quite handy. Right, as for climbing hardware, this is sort of the basic rack that I'll take on every route I do. I've got some pitons on there and 2 ice screws. These are really handy, the DMM Bulldogs, Black Diamond do a version as well. They're basically just an ice axe without a handle. They're really good for hammering into frozen cracks, and they're really, really handy for hammering into frozen turf. Carry 4 hexes. It's just really handy, useful sizes, lightweight, give quite a lot of extension. Then your nuts, I carry the 11 DMM walnuts. Just some cheap, really versatile things. I then carry 8 quick tools with me, 5 standard length ones. I always carry a shock absorbing quick draw when I'm ice climbing. If you put it on sort of really dodgy nuts or really sketchy ice screws, the idea is that when you fall, the thing will zipper, taking a lot of shock out of the system. I also carry 2 extended quick draws. These ones they're 60 centimetre slings. You can extend them out, just give you again a bit more versatility. On top of that, carry a few extra snap gates, a few extra screw gates for setting up belays, and then about 3 or 4 slings, again just for setting up belays, wrapping around threads. Here I've got 3 120s and 1 240. That's all I carry on any Scottish route. Then, depending on the route that I'm doing, if it's a more ice climb than anything else, I may add a few more screws. Also a bollock thread. If I'm planning something a bit more icy, like 5-fingered gurley or something like that on the North Face Benders, I'll obviously take a few more screws with me. If it's going to be a more rock-based mixed climb, I'll probably take maybe another set of nuts, and possibly, if it's going to be a very long route over 25 metres, I may add 2 more quick draws to the 8 that I'm already carrying, which gives me a bit more versatility. Allows me just to climb slightly longer routes. If I'm going for something really hard on mixed ground, I may take cams with me as well. Now, this is sort of a bit of an odd one, really. Cams in Scotland don't always work because if the side of the crack is got ice on it, they can slip. So you've got to be really, really careful using cams in Scotland. And there's only certain situations, because carrying 5 cams are quite heavy. There are those things which are really route dependent and really depends on what I'm looking at. But sometimes it's all that really works. So you've always got to have some with you on some routes. Other stuff is the water bottle. I'm not a massive fan of using the platypus or camelback style water bladders in Scotland. The pipe comes on your shoulder, it almost freezes, you've got to keep blowing it back. It just tends to get on my nerves, and perfect for summer alpine or hiking, but just for Scottish winter they just freeze. So what I do is I use a Nalgene bottle in an insulated pouch. That sits in the bottom of my bag, the water never freezes in it. I can actually clip it, velcro it to my backpack on the walk in if I want lots of water. And the other thing is people tend to always carry quite a lot of water in Scotland. I only carry a litre. And I think that's absolutely fine. I don't really think you need that much water when you're climbing, especially in Scotland, because it is quite cold. You don't dehydrate. Other things I carry are the map and the guidebook. I keep it all in a sort of waterproof case. I keep the guidebook with my route descriptions on there, and then the map on the outside, and then also your compass and whistle, and that sort of sits nicely in my backpack. I can get at it easily, and it's nice and waterproof, so it doesn't get damaged. Other things, goggles, really, really important piece for Scotland. ideally, don't really want to use them. If the weather comes in and snow and spin drift, or if you're climbing up a gully where you've got lots of snow coming down, just nothing really beats these. And you know, for such a minimal amount of weight, they're just really handy to have in your backpack. And also, you know, you reach out, get on top of the Cairngorm Plateau, and it's blowing hooly. You just really need these to navigate off. Other things are by keeping my little dry bags or my emergency bits and bobs. I've got in here a head torch. I'd personally use the Petzl Myo XP. Really, really bright torch, lots of different functions, really good battery life. Really, really like that head torch. Other things, I carry a spare pair of Buffalo mitts, just in case I lose all my other gloves. Or my partner loses gloves. Really, really warm. And they're only 50 grams, and they're, you know, brilliant, brilliant gloves. Got your toilet roll, in case you need it. And then the other thing I also carry is the Petzl E-Lite. I actually weighed this the other day, and this actually weighs less than three spare batteries for my Myo XP. Tiny little torch, really, really bright. And yeah, the fact that it actually weighs less than three batteries for my spare torch for my Myo, I think it's a really, really good little piece. That comes in this little pot, and you know, sometimes even, you know, during the summer, if I'm doing a big route, say in North Wales, I'll actually just clip that to the back of my harness, because ideally I don't want to be getting off in the dark, but at the same time, I do still want a head torch if I do. Other things, important to a lot of people, the little camera. I've got this sort of little digital camera. I don't spend loads on digital cameras for Scottish and Alpine. Thing is that, you know, they get bashed, they do get damaged. And I keep on with nice bit of string, so it always keeps it in its pouch. I always try to find a nice insulated pouch for my camera as well. The Low Pro do quite a good range here. Again, just because it's so cold in Scotland, the batteries can freeze, and you know, just keeping it warm, I always keep it in my chest pocket here. And then finally, last thing to look at really is the backpack stuff that this is all going to go in. For the last sort of 8 years, I've been using the Pod Black Ice. Really good back system, find it really comfortable. Hip has removers, got little gear loops on there. The only thing I do with my bags, I do a few mods to them. First thing I do is cut the lid off them. I find they sort of get in the way and they sort of slide to one side when they're empty. So I sort of just get rid of those and just have it on the drawer cord at the top. The other thing I do is I replace all of the cord, the drawer cords in my bag with prusik loop. This is 4-5mm cord. The reason I do that is you've got to carry this stuff anyway, you might as well make it something useful. So, you know, if I get stuck or I don't have enough prusik loops with me, I can pull this out of my bag, I can use it prusik, I can abseil off this. Like I said, you've got to carry it anyway, you might as well make it work for you. Other things I like about this bag, you know, good drawer cords, some side pockets on there, although, like I said, I tend to really like having things on the outside of my bag. It's got some little loops on there that you can shove your axe into if you need to, and some shock cord in the front for carrying your crampons. That's what I'm going to be using in Scotland this year. Hope everyone enjoys it.
Thank you.